not a question of belief. Trying to maintain, but a matter of experience. Experience has gradually become successful through the energetic application that one self forces to content such as the ones contained in this book. Forward XXIX. Seeking enlivening of one's thinking is only one aspect of this path of development. The characterization of our thinking faculty as needed with higher capacities is also applicable to many aspects of the human being. How other human faculties can be constantly tuned so as to become organs of higher experience is the primary content of Chapter 4. Already in the first pages of Theosophy, a description of various tribes of the human being was given, showing different ways of using your connected with the world through perception, feeling, mood, and thinking. Whereas the first chapter remains primarily a description of these faculties, at the end of Theosophy they are viewed from a developmental perspective. Although a healthy expansion of human consciousness begins with the faculty of thinking, it can only be realized at deeper levels when a human being is transformed. Chapter 4 shows the characteristic type of transformation the individual must undertake in order to overcome the separation from the deeper aspects of reality created by the limitations of our everyday human colony. This transformation, as Steiner describes it here, must be realized through the efforts of the human I itself. This poor, large, self-conscious being, see Chapter 1, must take on this task for their own wonders. Emphasizing this is essential to Steiner's view of the human being. The path of development which he represents could not happen if the human being was brought about through the growing forces of the individuality I itself. Passing out of insight into the hindrances that is bears within his own bodily and soul nature, the human I can. Step forward. Discovering that obligation in preparing this new edition. This premier four-point test variety will be called thoroughly revised and updated. Rudolf Steiner Berlin. July 1918. Core Theosophy. Preface 5. Preface to the 6th edition. Almost every time it has become necessary to reprint this book, I have set myself the task of carefully reviewing and revising its content. This time is no exception, but what I have to say about this new edition is similar to what I had to say about the 3rd edition, so I can retain the credits for this printing. However, this time I have taken particular care to express many details with greater clarity than I have been capable of doing in any of the previous editions, although Should also make